Password security strategy involves primarily using long passwords. So long passwords are much more effective than short passwords, even with complexity. Actually, what is recommended now is to use passphrases. So that would be a sentence. And actually, a sentence of known words is better than a 15-character or 10-character password that has mixed characters and letters and numbers. So really, the recommendation now is for using password phrases. NIST now does not necessarily recommend resetting your password. We still think it's a good idea because if your password should be had through malware or hacked where it's stored for a third party, when you reset your password, you're actually re-securing your account. So while changing your password is becoming less recommended, we still think it's a good idea. NIST is a government regulatory body that creates standards and procedures it's NIST 853, is a standard that has associated procedures for recommended security controls. A good way to protect your passwords and good password strategy is to actually set a different password for every account that requires a username and password. So having a different username and password for every account isolates those. If one gets compromised, the others are not. Okay, but how do you remember all of your passwords? There are a lot of really decent commercial password safes or password databases nowadays. All you need to do really is Google commercial passwords, look for reviews, and select one that's well recommended behind a company that's well established. And what that password safe does for you is it allows you to have that one very strong password to unlock the password safe. And once you've unlocked the password safe, you store those complex passwords. Most of them include password generators that create that really complex long password for you that you don't have to remember. And then really it's a matter of either copying and pasting that password into your application. Some of them integrate with web browsers to make it a little bit more seamless. But then you have a password database, and it doesn't really matter to you how many passwords you have or what their complexity is. It's stored and saved and managed for you. I think I have probably over 200 passwords nowadays. And I don't remember what any of them are, including my George Mason password. The university enforces password changes every 180 days. And the password complexity requirement that the university requires is a password 10 characters or greater. There is a limit, a technical limit to 20 characters. It's a programmatic limit because some applications on campus can't handle passwords larger than 20 characters. The complexity requirement is 3 out of 4 character sets. The character sets are alphanumeric and special character, uppercase, lowercase, number, and unfortunately this time we're only allowing for a exclamation point as the special character. It's a bit of an issue with our Oracle-based applications. If a student doesn't know what their password is, they can always go to the IT Support Center, which is located on the main floor of Innovation Hall. If students know what their password is, they can go to password.gmu.edu. That's the online application that is used to reset passwords. Applications that use university NetIDs are primarily ones that are supported by central IT, although there are web applications supported by departments that also use central authentication. How that's done is through one of two different middleware applications or applications in between the service and our authentication system that helps with that authentication process. The first one is called CAS, and that stands for Central Authentication Services. And the second one is called Shibboleth. Both of them work in this way. You go to the primary application, for instance, password.gmu.edu. You are redirected to the Common Authentication System, CAS. You enter your username and password, and then CAS forwards back to password.gmu.edu or patriotweb.gmu.edu. It forwards back a token, and the token is basically a statement back to that application that the user is who they say they are. It's an affirmation of identity. So both CAS and Shibboleth work that way, and most applications across the university that require authentication will use one or the other of those two systems.